Wait, what was that?
That was the funniest.
Don't ask, don't tell. Anyway, it's the British Grand Prix. Yay.
Great opening there.
That was awesome.
It's the British Grand
Prix. And I saw the start screen instead of this screen, and it's raining. I was going to make a comment about the weather straight off the bat, and then Bortz totally trolled me and opened up with a different screen than I was expecting. I hate him. Anyway, I am at Ruda again, yada yada yada. Joining me is Valentin from Moscow and Marvin from I don't know where.
Düsseldorf. Yeah.
oh no. Yeah, what's up everybody?
So we can see the rain coming down as we see the qualifying results. The Lotus is not doing too well down in the bottom end. Weber doing shit down at 18th. Must have been a weird qualifying. Except Button,
P14. Good job, Button.
Rain.
Crash into the mall or something?
Oh, wait. Q, 0% rain. Interesting.
Yeah. Very weird. But it is coming down now. Bortz looking like he's going to start on the inter tire, showing you his setup and all that business. 1-1 wings in the rain. It's going to be a fun time for everybody. Yeah, should be an interesting race. Should be more interesting than the last one we watched, by far. Although I don't really remember the last one that we watched, to be honest. It was Valencia. I was sick, tired, and on medication.
Can we not speak about Valencia?
That's
okay. Yeah.
Freaked out. I remember Valencia.
That Spanish track. No, there's
yeah, that track that only gets interesting if they finally open up that bridge.
Yeah, I know. Well, I put my idea for how to improve Valencia. People seem to like it, but it said they just got rid of the track, which I don't care. It doesn't matter to me.
They did. There's no way they did. It's still being raced.
No, it's not.
We had this argument before, and I told you it's still an event in MotoGP.
Yeah, I'm not saying they got rid of it altogether. For F1.
Oh, well, yes.
Idiot. So that's a high quality professional podcasting that you get from us here, or race casting, rather. This is only. It's looking like Bortz just doing some kind of strategy stuff, trying to leave gaps in there in case weather changes, gets worse, gets better.
Race strategy?
No,
it's fucking minutes into the video. What is he doing?
What?
There we go. Going to track. There we go. Good. Oh, I hope there's so much head wobbling right now.
Here comes Valentin.
Do it, Bortz. Bortz, do it.
Do it, Bortz.
Yeah.
I'm trying to follow the head with my head movements, and I'll.
Oh, he didn't whip it back and forth to that much. That's sad.
On pole, and some Ferrari second.
Gonna be interesting. Here we go, starting P15 at a very high angle. And here we go, one light, two light, three light, four light, five light, rev that engine, baby. And we are away. Bortz getting the customary wheel spin off the line. Second gear, not wanting to grab, but he finally gets it. And flicks it up to Rich. Oh god, here we go with the field again. Grosjean trying to pass him on the inside. Not gonna work. Whoa! And
actually, two positions off the start, I think.
Yeah, that's a Weber-esque start there.
Yeah.
Raikkonen is having trouble with his grip. It takes somebody, and then Bortz is gonna take Grosjean on the outside. Is he? Is Grosjean gonna crash? No!
Oh!
Maldonado, what the?
He escaped the penalty for that one. That was a clear cut track with an overtake.
I thought.
Fuck. This game is first. That was not a legal move. That would not have. That shit would not fly. Actually.
Well, what would you do if you see Maldonado like that? Like you want to evade that shit like instantly.
Want to get out? No. Yeah, I could. As we're now stuck behind Aresta in P7.
So much for the Weber's start. Like lose two positions on the grid and just get like
off the track. Yeah.
10 in the next corners.
It was marginal.
And that was a great move, okay.
That was like, yeah.
A work.
Again, like Weber on Vettel, kinda, 2010.
Okay, so he's firmly behind the rest of, but the rest isn't quick enough to keep up with the top five. Kobayashi's right there. And there's a Duresta train right now.
Oh, somebody crashed.
That was a crash. Lots of crashing there.
Kobayashi, what did you do?
Something did happen with Kobayashi, clearly. So now it's Senna, I think. Yeah.
Yeah.
And now suddenly 3 second gap materialized fucking out of nowhere. Still 24 cars in the race.
Yeah, that would have been a safety car if one of them had gone out.
Yeah.
Or it's taking a lot of curb. Really risky with low downforce taking all that curb. It very easily snap on you and you lose the back end. But Bortz, ooh, a little bit off track there. Not too bad. Now all of a sudden, Duresta has decided he wants to speed up.
Yeah. He's catching up to the leaders, and Bortz is kind of sort of hanging back there.
I'm going to assume no DRS.
Oh, hell no.
Not in those conditions, no.
A little bit of aquaplaning there.
It's actually quite...
a little bit, yeah. Quite a lot.
Might be, if it keeps raining, might be wet tires soon.
Yeah. Duresta kinda sort of establishing a gap, not like a tremendous one, but it's there. Same distance to Senna, from what I can tell. I don't know who's behind.
Further behind than Duresta is ahead, but... relatively close.
As it was before. I didn't close up.
Here's where all the Bortz's advantage is going to be on the straightaway.
Bortz is pretty lucky that lots of people seem to have jeopardized their races already.
I think he gambled on qualifying. Trying to set up.
Yeah, that's what I imagine.
If I was going to sacrifice Quali. Which if I knew, I mean, it was 100% chance of rain, I would have gone for it. I would have sacrificed. And...
Matt's fault. All Matt's fault.
I hate you. I'm going to play it off.
Yeah, we blame Matt.
Oh, Lord. I blame people in my apartment building who also use Comcast. Comcast sucks. Never, ever get it. Anywho... race confirmed is wet. Well, no shit. Is now trailing Duresta once again.
You see, there's some lonely car back in the previous sector. Previous lap, even, I think.
Looks like he's in pace to both Duresta and the Ferrari in front of him.
Yeah.
Bortz might be able to. Oh!
Whoa!
That is not helpful. Didn't seem to cost him too much time, so that's good, but...
it's really weird conditions. It's too wet for inters, but it's not wet enough for wets. It's, like, kind of midway.
I think it's time for safety car rest, like that shit, and just...
yeah.
Restart the race in 4 hours or something.
I much agree.
I agree completely.
That's what Bernie would do now. Or rather, Charlie Whiting.
No, I don't even think it's Charlie. I think it's old senile Bernie.
I would blame him. This does not look safe.
Although, you know, it could be worse. We could have Tamara Eccleston leading it.
Yeah.
Worse things could happen.
Yes. They could, but let's hope they won't.
I wonder who's going to take Bernie's place when he does die. Not to be morbid or cruel, but, you know, it's going to happen. So, you know, when it...
I don't really care who's gonna take over, but how's F1 gonna cope with it in general? Like,
some teams in a funeral and a token show of appreciation, and that'll be it.
No, like, how will F1 be still the same after he's gone?
I think it can only get better from here.
I don't. he's a
yeah,
shady morals and all, but. God.
Oh no, he's got his shit together. I'm not saying he don't, but
that's what I'm saying. I do hope that whoever comes in to replace him for whatever reason, whether it's because he's too old or, you know, I hope the licensing is a lot less strict than it is right now.
Maybe we can get online races.
Yeah, and like, I hope, like NASCAR does and stuff.
Yeah, like we can watch, or like IndyCar, like watch the races on YouTube or something.
Upload it. V8.
I hope it's somebody younger, just, you know, with a more fan perspective on it.
Well, it can't be much older, can it?
Sure.
Maldonado, fastest lap of the race. Oh my god, how did he do that? He cut the corner somewhere.
He's in clear air. After he crapped. And it up! Ooh! Almost went up to rest his ass there.
That's one hell of an overtake.
In the wet, yeah.
Out, stuck. If ridiculously dangerous.
Well, there's no other way to overtake in the wet. All of this is ridiculously dangerous.
Oh god, okay. Now when I see Perez, I expect a McLaren. The switch in my brain finally complete.
I still do.
I do, yeah.
I'm not used to Perez in a McLaren. I'm still not used to Lewis in a Mercedes.
He's neither. English too hard.
Yeah, English is fine.
You think
Perez has much of a shot at a podium this year?
Yes.
Well, I get down the middle then. Unless, what do you think, Valentin?
I don't, no.
Awesome, too. We went overly, Marvin. Suck it.
If McLaren gets their shit together, which I think they do, because they're McLaren and they'll just throw money at that car until it behaves like it should.
Like infinite cash resources, like certain Italian teams, isn't it?
Or so they got enough.
But I don't.
And once the car is competitive enough, I feel like Perez can do pretty good.
I think Button will be on the podium. I think Button will even win.
Probably, yeah.
I don't think Button's gonna win. I don't think either of them are gonna win. I think it's gonna be a winless year for McLaren. Putting it out there right now.
Didn't he Lewis like win in 2009 and stuff? I mean,
09. I think yes.
Let's check.
Afraid to get out of my video.
Yeah, he did twice.
But then,
oh, and we totally missed how he passed. There
it is. It was on the straight. It was an easy pass, nothing eventful. The thing is, though, is that McLaren always has a whole huge-ass dip in form after major rule regulation. See 2009, see 2006, see 2000 and... or not even 2000, 1994. Or, excuse me, 95. They always plummet after a regulation change, so does Newey. So, it'll be interesting to see what happens to McLaren and Red Bull if Red Bull retains Newey. And, also, I think it'll be the first time, though, that they followed a regulation change or preceded a regulation change by a shitty season if the season continues down the hill. So, it'll be interesting to see what they do about that.
Well, it's already pretty shitty.
If it doesn't improve. Actually, you know what? No. Was their 94 campaign good or bad? I can't remember.
For luck of me. I don't think it was good, but... because I know who fought for the title and weren't McLaren drivers.
Well, we are now catching the leaders by quite a margin. There's one way out front. I can guess who that is.
Can't be better. He would be further away.
Lewis, actually.
Yeah, some of them.
I guess. It's wet, it's British, it's Hamilton.
No, actually, it's wet, it's British, it's somebody else, but, yeah. There's other drivers. British. the way.
Talk about the British track.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alonso currently running ahead. Gap now same to Alonso as it is to Perez behind. Kobayashi sets fastest lap. Well, at least this game kind of represents Stauber's 2012 pace in the wet. Good. Doesn't represent McLaren's pace in the wet, but, you know.
Yeah.
Okay, he's reeling him in. Wow.
Sure. This sector alone is making up hordes of time. Hordes of time? That didn't make any sense. It sounds like a really bad fantasy game.
Sounds like a really bad band.
Oh, look at the fuel. Right now it's optimal, but...
Alonso's looking like he's gonna make a move, and ooh, he looks like he's getting a bit slippy there. Trying to make a move on the outside of whoever the fuck that is. Alonso loses a bit of control and doesn't make it sick, and critically, Bortz is now off his ass.
Far ahead of him, also Ferrari.
Schumacher.
Yeah, I cannot afford to watch an higher quality.
I don't understand what that hitch was about, though, because it's now the auto quality has put me back up to HD, so I don't know why that video stopped. Oh, off the track a little bit, but everyone should do that at some point. It is. Yeah, I'd get up the way.
How, that was the grass, right? He should have just spun out there. In the wet, get on the grass, you're just like...
Codemasters doesn't know how to program traction correctly.
No, they just don't want to make this game too unforgivable, pretty much.
They just don't care.
No, it's not
People
bad.
Are gonna buy it anyways.
It's not bad. It really, I heard why they do it, and it's the same reason why they don't implement a better fucking damage system. It's because they want it to be easier.
The licensing prevents better damage.
Yeah.
Well, have more parts is because they're like, oh my god, they can't touch the Formula One car crash. But then you
didn't stop Grand Prix 4.
It was during the era where there were where the FOM wasn't a bunch of I'm not gonna say that.
Well, okay, we're really close to Alonso now.
So we are right on Fernando.
Yep. Second has run away. Oh my god.
Schumacher's gone. Fernando up big time.
Oh, whoever's in first. Yeah, Hamilton's gone completely.
Alonso trying to outside move again, but it ain't gonna work. He's losing even more pace. Bortz is right on his gearbox. Is he gonna try a bonsai then the inside?
Guys, I think we missed something. Weren't we running in fifth behind Alonso, and now we're in fourth?
Second place, though. Why are there only 23 cars on the track?
Cars, yeah. Okay.
When did that?
I don't know. It. What happened?
Or crash or anything like that.
Maybe second place dove into the pits and somebody else crashed.
Maybe. Why would they come in though?
I think I saw anybody in the pits at any point. I would see that on the minimap.
Well, who is this? It's a Red
Bull. Did you watch the minimap?
It was a Red Bull, wasn't it? It was... Angry Boy? Nice, Bortz. Nicely held.
Yeah, that could have ended really badly. It sort of did, but, yeah.
Could have ended worse.
Yeah. Pretty much. Alonso still trying to find a way past Schumacher.
He's probably just fast around the straights, but not fast enough and can't really man.
Usually it's the other way around with Ferrari and Mercedes, but...
Look, like, he's doing it again. He's trying to pass him right there.
God.
So, Ferrari is quicker on the straights.
He's trying actually an outside pass. I can't see whether it worked or not, but whatever.
No.
It's as you were, pretty much holding station.
And Bortz catching up to them at a very rapid pace again. Kind of so is Perez, kind of sort of. And Lewis nowhere to be seen. Says they need to do better than a low 1 minute 48. Okay.
Those guys shifted way down way earlier than Bortz did just then.
You told them by the sound, I imagine?
Well, I mean, no, but I'm saying relative to position.
Oh.
I'm just trying to figure out how Bortz is catching him, and I'm wondering if he's just getting more traction with the higher gears than the AI. It seems like it. So running full revs, trying to get himself by Shumi.
No, he's trying to create a gap. The engineer knows better, clearly.
What about Hulkenberg, though?
Ooh, that was a bit cheeky.
That is a good question.
What's really? Our fuel status now?
Really sucks that the game won't show the gap to Hamilton. That's a quite some twist. Are we seeing a
lot?
Wow.
Nice. And Bortz was going to
Won't take Andrew quite as long to pass Schumacher as it did Alonso.
The only problem is I think Schumacher was holding Alonso up massively, so now Fernando is going to fly off into the distance. So even if Bortz gets past Schumacher, it's going to be a tall ask to get himself up the next two positions. Maybe three, depending on if P2 went into the pits or crashed out, wherever he may be. It's going to be interesting for sure. Lap 11 to 52. Rain coming down. Seems to be a bit lighter now.
Yeah.
Not... Bortz is definitely shifting down at different times in the AI. I think that might be why he's able to get so much more exit grip from them.
Zo is nowhere to be seen already. Well, he's on the mini-map, but I can't...
Not for long. He's not going to be there for long. Bortz is going to pass him on the straight now. Probably the same way Alonso tried to three times. There we go, upstream.
Come on!
Whoa, Schumacher, what the?
Some questionable defending from the AI there. Pretty sure there was a double change of line.
Bortz, Hamilton's going to come in the pits, and Bortz can't make the move. He was trying to get the crisscross on Schumi, but it didn't work. Wasn't far enough along his outside enough to... I just botched that sentence, but you know what I mean. It's a little bit of an overseer coming out of there. Perez has caught up to Bortz and is now going to start making a move. Alonso has the fast lap of the race. Lewis is going to have to watch out. Shit just got really interesting here.
Yeah.
I say all of that, expecting some backing to my commentary, and all I get is, yeah, now you see the conditions I work under, people.
Well, you know, if you're gonna solo, I might as well let you.
Ugh. I need a Crofty to my Brundle. I have two. Come on, people. Don't leave me hanging.
Right behind Schumacher again.
The sun. I think Marvin's falling asleep.
No, I'm still here.
He's by the beat. Ready.
I'm still waiting for Andrew to wiggle his head around. It's gonna happen at some point.
Taking a lot.
Oh. That was an interesting line through.
Yeah, he's taking that line through. How the car's called?
Egerton Beckett.
Yep. Thank you. And now he's gonna do the same thing again, inside line. Coming out, and Schumacher's probably.
Same outcome. No, he has it.
Fuck off.
Door on him.
But look at Paris. Paris is right behind Schumacher now.
Yeah, no pace on Schumi.
And also nice clean air.
Yeah, okay, so he's already 8 seconds behind Alonso, and Alonso's pumping out fastest laps. And Bortz is not.
Very well observed. Although, has Hamilton come pit stop?
I guess not, we would have seen him.
He was supposed to come in on the pit stop, like, why do we even have this race engineer, fella?
Well, I ask because if he has, the gap between him and Alonso is a lot bigger than I thought it was.
Oh, I doubt it. I really do doubt it. Now, if he did, this race is fucking over, but I don't...
Looks like somebody's forming a train back there in the midfield. As Schumacher is now holding someone else up. Surprise.
Yeah, Paris probably.
Yeah, definitely.
The Rainmeister. Not so meistery. Meisterhaft in the rain.
German with Marvin.
It's show. You know, next season I want to see what's the salt of the bot out there that makes AI attack a lot more, defend a lot more. It has like mechanical return the shitty teams.
Oh.
Or actual mistakes and all that from them. I'd like to see him put that on.
I've seen like Steve use that for F1 2011, was it?
Yeah. It's like, whoa, and again on the grass there, there would have been a spin probably, in reality.
Whoa, that was a weird shift pattern. What the hell is he doing there? What the hell is he doing?
Yeah, he's kind of struggling by the looks of it.
He just lost his line through that complex.
Concentration, and it didn't work.
Maybe. But then again, Bortz could, like, anyway, so.
And Bortz still losing time to Alonso now.
Needs to pit. I'm gonna guess the tires are
pretty well.
But what tires are the same for everyone?
Yeah. Well, no. No, that's not. That is not how modern F1 works.
No, it's here's some rubber. We don't know what we've done with it. Have fun.
Pretty much. I'm not going to argue that it doesn't make for fantastic racing, but that's how it works.
Yeah. I told, I forget who it was, it's Turkish guy. Some Turkish F1 dude, I can't remember his name. He was like talking about Pirelli's, like, what do you think about Bridgestones now? And I'm like, the Pirelli's now remind me of the Firestones we had in America in the mid-2000s, early 2000s.
You still have Firestones.
But in the early 2000s, there were a bunch of cases of them, like, spontaneously exploding and causing rollovers and hurting. It was a big thing around here, then, during that time. They were just disintegrating. So that's what Pirelli's remind me of. Bortz passing two backbunkers.
Two backbunkers in the pitch?
By him. Mixing him. Take of a line ends up ahead of him.
Yeah, there's finally going to be people to lap, so that should be fun.
Yeah, spice things up for sure. All this rain reminds me of the Battlefield 4 trailer.
Oh, I didn't actually see that yet.
It's fantastic.
Well, they showed single player, so what? I don't care about it.
It has Bonnie Tyler, okay? It's awesome.
What does it have?
Bonnie Tyler.
Oh, okay.
They showed single player. I don't care.
It's well done, though. You gotta admit, that was fun.
Yeah, like, yeah, the engine looks awesome.
Yeah, it's not like...
graphics look fantastic, but...
Or really, the shooting. Did they show the shooting? Did they show any of the shooting?
Yeah.
Yeah, they showed like 17 minutes of the campaign.
How many?
17.
Well, that's what I'm doing after the cast decided.
Yes. It's really, you know, oh!
Oh!
Oh! Oh! Go, Bortz!
Bortz just doing the drifting.
Can you drink?
Oh, style.
Yeah.
Arigato! Slide, oka, crash it! Like that. You said it. Yeah. I should.
A bit less offensive.
Side by side, crash it! Arigato, crash it!
Japanese commentators do their commentary in horribly broken English.
I love it. That's why we need to get tacky on here for one of these. My ultimate dream team commentary team would be Tacky and Kimmy.
Oh god.
Yes. He's in that bitch.
Yes, he left. He's turning left. He is turning right. His tires look good.
That motherfucker has crashed again. That is not okay. I wonder if Maldonado's gonna finish a single race this year.
Of course.
Well, he's one of the most consistent guys so far this season. It's him, it's Maldonado and Ricciardo are the most consistent guys of the season so far. Maldonado DNFing both times because he can't fucking drive, and Ricciardo because his exhaust is, like, destroying itself, it seems.
I wonder what that is. It's not hurting Jeb. Is it another case of the Australian and the Red Bull team gets fucked?
Maybe, we don't know. You'd have to ask Marco about that.
I don't... if I ever met that man, I'd punch him and be sued. But... you hear stories about Red Bull's potentially going to be getting a chick in F1.
Bates Gavissa? Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
It is cool, actually, considering she's pretty talented from what we've...
She's cute.
Sorry, what?
She's pretty cute.
Yeah.
Wait, before I say that, how old is she?
Below legal age, as of now, as far as I remember.
No, they're getting her into the feeder series. She's probably younger than I am.
Yes, most definitely. She's either 17 or 18.
Oh, okay. Near enough is makes no difference. Legally covered. Okay.
Terrible. Oh, God.
Oh, so, yeah, I did actually forget that she... I was like, wait, she's probably really young. She doesn't look that young, though. She does look good. She's beautiful.
She's an ass-kicking driver, actually.
I've read about her repertoire, and that's what we need. We don't need a Susie Wolf who really can't drive, although she is cute. You know what I mean? If we got to get a woman in F1, I want because she can drive her ass off first.
Yeah, it's not like it's not gonna help like that stereotype if we get a woman in F1 and
if we,
yeah,
just driving in the back of the pack every single race. We need somebody who's just kicking ass.
No, she.
Yeah. Get something really capable.
That would be awesome.
This circuit seems pretty capable. She's not like the best driver from around those German-esque series, but she's pretty good.
Oh, that horse coming through though. Oh my god, that's some understeer. He took way too fast.
Look at his left front, it's basically
driver. Yes, Mark.
I'm trying to see. Whoa, that almost looks like a slick at speed. He's gonna need to come in and get some new rubber. Now, use too much.
He's not catching it. He's not really pulling away from Schumacher. He's not really catching Alonso. He's not even. Well, he is catching Kovalainen.
F.
Oh.
Is that the pit entrance or did what? Oh, okay, it is.
Yeah.
Now, I think
somebody.
Alonso in the pits.
Yep.
Yeah.
Whoa!
Jesus Christ.
You are taking the Japanese lines through this course.
this tire gambling is, I don't know, it's a bit bizarre. Is he trying to wait out till it gets dry? Because it ain't gonna get dry enough.
The grass in that one, that was the tires. He just hooked the grass and the curb.
Oh. Okay. Yeah, but the tires are clearly shot to shit. Yeah.
Which won't matter in this corner, but coming up it will. Let's badly takes it. God, it has to slow down so much. Right hand corners, he's blown. And not in the fun way.
Thank you for clarifying.
Here we go. Trip! Ooh, we'll brace for grass as we go off the track.
Now, I don't really see what he's trying to do here. Like, might as well have fitted as early as possible, because I don't think this is going to keep up for the...
He might be trying to two-stop.
It's... No, well, he'll have to... The point when he has to switch from inters to dries does not depend on how many compounds he's used up, does it?
I'm assuming that he's assuming it's not going to stop.
Okay.
So 19... to, so that'd be 19:37:50. Yeah, he could two stop now.
Pull a Raikkonen.
Yeah. Just stop one time less than everyone else, and with the gap to Alonso, if he can hold the gap to Alonso at about 16 seconds, or no, that's Hamilton. Oops. Getting Hamilton is still going to be a tough ask, but. Alonso, I think, could definitely be within his reach if he can do one less stop than everyone else. We'll have to wait and see. Once he might actually follow his pre-race strategy.
Yeah.
See, Alonso... Oh, wait, Alonso jumped Hamilton. That's Alonso and Hamilton right in front of him. Holy shit.
What? How did that happen?
Alonso posted some fastest laps, and then maybe a botched pit stop by Hamilton. I don't know if the AI gets botched pit stops, but...
It's about a typical McLaren is now...
I am so much closer to both of them. Like, seriously, did they put on the fucking dry tires or something? I don't...
Well, we'll have to see. I doubt it. And these conditions are sort of a pseudo-wet inter kind of mixture.
Enter. I'd say they're definitely enter, but...
Well, yeah, no, I'm not saying Bortz on the wrong tire, but I'm saying that if it rained a little bit harder, I think... cooling. They're just barely able to wait. Is that even... It's not even... That's not even fucking... That's not... Wait. So then is that Felipe ahead of us?
No, it's clearly Lewis.
Wait, but... I thought there was a... Oh, wait, where did that...
Lewis, wasn't Lewis like 16-7? Yeah, he's 18 seconds behind Hamilton.
Well, is it a guy we need to lap then? I don't...
Yeah.
Russia, I bet.
How do you think of it? Yeah,
I
it is.
I said, and then silver, like it's like white, and I thought it was silver. So I thought it was Ferrari McLaren. Okay, that makes a bit more sense.
Information.
That was...
Yeah, and obviously, but Alonso did seemingly jump Hamilton.
No, he did jump Hamilton for sure, and that's why I thought red, white was Ferrari and McLaren, which is where I got confused. But if we can maintain the gap to Hamilton and do one less stop than him, we could definitely have him. Because it's definitely a 25-ish second pit stop around here in the best of times. We'll have to see. We'll have to see what the AI deal. On what the AI do. They all came in around, what, 15-ish?
Yeah.
Let's say 15 at the maximum. That would mean 15, 30, 45. That's pushing it. They'd have to push on one extra stint, but they could do it. The guys who came in earlier than lap 15 are definitely on three stop. I wish there was some way that, you know, if this game actually had a decent replay system that we didn't have to watch through YouTube and we could actually see information, make my job a lot easier. But, alas, Codemasters. Now, who are out?
Looks like Michael Schumacher is sud and
suddenly a lot quicker than everybody, it seems.
Suddenly he found his Rainmeister jeans.
Yeah. They were next to his Cisco Tech pants.
Sorry, what pants? What?
Cisco Tech?
Oh. Okay, never mind.
Yeah, it is Schumacher. 0.5 seconds behind Bortz.
That looks like a lot less than half a second.
Yeah. Although, still no arrow. Now there's the arrow.
Trolled.
Trolled by the game.
Welcome to Formula One. Here comes Shumi, there goes Shumi. I think he's gonna make a dive.
No, the AI is probably just too cautious.
Well, it should be after all. I'd be cautious too if I were him.
But he isn't.
True. Very true. I would never.
Well, Schumacher is running a full rest. What about Bortz though? Did he switch up to high again, like super fast stuff?
Crash. Thank you, Andrew. Still fresh. Isn't this so exciting to look at? They're still fresh.
Well, maybe they will just like snap to red.
Alonso with another fastest lap, and it's 3 seconds quicker than Bortz's fastest effort. God. Well, okay, now Bortz has a fastest effort. That's obviously quicker than his previous one, but still. Mad pace. Still haven't had a chance to figure out who that poor chap in second who retired was, if it was even him. Did Matt disappear?
No, I'm reading that apparently Vettel was freaking out after he overtook Weber.
Well,
out as in?
Like on the radio sounding like he was freaking out.
Like freaking out like, oh my god, they're gonna kick me off the team, or?
If I'm reading it correctly, like, oh my god, I really just fucked up. And that he was scared of Mark. Oh my god, Seb, you're an idiot. Let's not go there again.
Well, we still have like 45 minutes. Time, like, we can do this all over again.
We need you to get some heat into the brakes. Brake hard into the next couple of corners.
Yes, or as opposed to what, engineer? Braking lightly and then spearing off into the wall? It's the corner after a freaking straight. What do you think we're gonna do?
Well, Maldonado is still not sure what to do with the corner.
Oh, too true.
Especially if there's another car in there.
Yes.
Well, Bortz is speeding up lap after lap. Wonder if he's finding his braking zones and stuff, or whether it's just, well...
The fuel level decreasing?
Nah, the fuel does not decrease that much. No way.
The tire's coming back.
The rain
is significantly lighter.
Yeah. So it's getting drier.
Good call, Valentin.
It's like fucking Davidson-like analysis here, okay?
He's good now that he doesn't have to play off of some dumb bimbo.
I'm being sarcastic. No, I actually think Ant is pretty great.
Yeah. I just... it was so awkward him having to play out, you know, over top of, oh my god, we cover their fab, might look at my titty,
She didn't actually, come on, man, that's sexist, seriously, she didn't say anything like that. She didn't actually contribute anything, pretty much, yeah, but...
No, I don't say that about Pinkham. Natalie Pinkham is brilliant, I love her.
Pinkham is brilliant.
Her with me. What did you do? Stick hug, yeah.
Didn't see how the new Susie Perry at BBC does?
Wait, I don't know about BBC, but the new pit lane chick they have at Sky is kind of it.
I don't know that.
He's just...
I don't even know who you're talking about.
Either. No.
There's another girl who does commentary from the pit lane. I don't know if it's races, but they're different sessions.
If I were them, I'd just get, like, DC to run around. I know he's with BBC, but...
Long network, buddy.
Yeah, I know.
Alright, Hakey, blue flags. Move your shit.
Fucking idea to split commentary teams. God. Like, just get the entire fucking... BBC cast over to Sky and then air the same thing on BBC. Bam.
Yeah, that would be too easy. That would be too easy.
Yeah, I guess. It's not like they're reporting losses with this type of thing because not as many people watch Bates. Oh, wait. Yes. Yes, they are. Awkward silence.
Well, there's not much going on. And Andrew is posting some pretty fast laps, but he's not really catching Hamilton, who is like 26 seconds off?
Something like that, about a pit stop.
And he's not really pulling away from Schumacher and that group that's forming there. So... 24.5 seconds to Hamilton, yeah. So there's lots of clean air in front of him. His tire is getting a little bit yellow.
How many high energy left-hand corners are there, or right-hand corners are there? There's... there's...
Not much else to do at the moment.
Two. There are two real high energy. I would say there would be high energy left here. Don't know why. Right front is wearing first, but.
What left front is wearing first?
Thing. This and then the one coming off the straight are the only two high energy right hand corners I can think of. This is even worse, I would say, and it's a left.
Well, no, just no.
There's like half the race to go. So
still losing time to Hamilton.
Looking at the time, I'm gonna imagine it gets like drier. Get quite a bit drier too, unless he crashes.
You never know. Still have 23 cars, so
there's half of the video to go, and we are not even at half point yet, and he's to
get half point then.
No, we're not. 20. This is lap 26, so we've completed 25 out of 52. Ta-da.
It depends on. Consider those numbers.
Well, yeah, I guess.
Hey, we are at basically half distance, plus or minus one lap, so you know what?
We're pretty much halfway, and there's fuel coming down, and...
You mean rain?
It's lighter.
No, like if the fuel load is going down.
You were talking about the rain, I was like, Marvin. No, you're right. I mean, times are only going to get faster from here.
Exactly, yeah.
And clear.
It's going to be a full race.
Well, let's hope it is. Let's hope he doesn't, like, crash out at lap 50 and leave us wondering what we have been doing for the last 2 hours.
But, that definitely was a Red Bull that we lost there. We lost whoever was in P2 in the first stint.
I wish there was a replay feature so we could see, huh?
Live within the race to show us where the cars are.
But that technology has not been invented.
Yeah, well, maybe just like a little line on the left side with like the like little dots on it to show where which car is. Like just show MSC for Schumacher right behind Bortz or something. Just so, show us like the relations. There.
Players only care where they're running. What is it? What does anything else matter?
Yeah, what do you think?
I mean, that would be helpful for like you as a player as well to know where your competition are, what the gaps are like between.
It's not to know you sometimes run against other drivers to compete for the championship in different positions over a race. Never happened.
No.
Seriously, though, such a shame that that fucking replay thing hasn't been invented yet, especially not by Forza Codemasters.
And it's such a shame that, you know, the replay systems that allow you to switch between cars haven't been invented yet. Oh, wait, Gran Turismo 2.
And probably came prior to that, I imagine.
Well, you can. In an online race, you actually can spectate other cars.
That doesn't even work particularly well.
Yeah, to be fair, the sound usually is fucked up.
Well, I haven't... Yeah. Okay, I mean, the feature is basically there.
Yeah.
They just have to do it so you can, like, record a race, and then you can watch it later with the replay feature. That would...
What's it called? What's that game they did that?
What do you mean?
They did that in one of their games.
No.
They didn't?
No, I played, like, pretty much all of them.
Maybe an old one.
Maybe. That could be. But no. Their replay systems have always been fucking atrocious.
You're right.
Race driver days, which was like 2003 or 4, that had a shit replay system. It never got better. Seriously, they better improve this stuff. Oh, this is not acceptable.
They won't.
Well, people keep buying it, so...
Like,
why should they make any changes? Like, they get so much money off of this. People keep buying the game, like...
For this shit, why can't Codemasters? I don't get it.
Just give the license to somebody else, or share it. It was better when we had competition, because then they actually had to try. Shit!
Okay,
my car.
Burning.
God damn it.
What happened?
I just spilled my coffee.
Top ball. Again, over your junk. As always.
Not up. Okay, actually, computer.
Only the computer, it should be fine. Because computers and fluids understand each other, like, very well.
My, we could go somewhere with that comment.
The George Takei impression. From Star Trek.
Yeah, I know George Takei.
I'm just, you know. You know what? If they give the license to Sports Interactive Games, who do the Football Manager series, I will shut up forever. There will be no more complaining. There will be.
Why don't I believe that?
I don't know. It'll be
fucking everything.
It's perfect.
It's about him complaining. You complain about your own complaining.
That is not true. I'm about you complaining about my complaining, so...
Complainception!
That's exactly the joke I was gonna say, you...
And now you're gonna complain about my joke about Matt complaining about your complaining that you complain about your complaining.
Right? Okay. I can pretty much fill out the rest of this commentary with that.
Yeah.
Making better sentences, that'd be awesome.
The Schumacher is pretty close.
Difficulty for me, apparently YouTube thought this video was only 55 minutes long, but I couldn't be so merciful. We're back. Bortz is still in the same place, being trailed by Schumacher in P3, lap 29, still raining like hell, and that's about all I got.
Absolutely nothing hilarious.
You cut that together, like, nobody's talking and suddenly we have technical difficulties and you start, like, talking for recapping everything.
And I'm laughing.
We're all laughing.
It's the most awkward cast I think I've done in a week.
Yeah,
you haven't been there for Valencia or what? Like,
I don't remember Valencia. Okay.
It's for the best, probably.
I haven't watched it either.
You shouldn't.
This rivals it in how bad it is.
No, this is just plain bad. The other one was
so bad it's good.
Yeah! Oh god.
Well, it's not our fault that Bortz can't make things interesting. Crash someone off. Cause a safety car.
Well, there's nobody to crash off!
Hit the brakes. Schumacher's behind you. He'll do it.
Oh, there's two. Wait.
Dude, he's out of the pits. Who is that? That's Car.
Well, who he's gonna lap.
Narain's not gonna let him by, because Narain's an idiot.
Kick. Oh, this is not looking. Oh.
And then it ended up being fine.
Yeah.
Although they did hold up the car's trailing boards quite a bit, so now there's a gap.
Yeah, there's a pass going on. No, it's not.
Not gonna matter, since they're getting right on his ass again, I'm gonna guess. And by the way, that two stopper proved completely useless, if it is what he's going for, which I think it is.
How so?
Well,
Hamilton is like 30 seconds up.
That's already more than one pit stop.
True. Again, like I said, the two stopper was going to be dependent on what the AI were able to do, and in this case, it looks like they were able to keep him at bay. So it looks like settle for P3. Curse is out.
Out isn't broken. Well, that's what he gets for racing in a Caterham, no fucking mercy.
Worst team ever. Now that HRT's gone, they...
La 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 la.
Fucking hell.
Sorry, Marvin, I still hate Marisha more.
Yes! I'm not the only one.
Marisha dog will pwn Caterham cat any day.
La 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 la. What?
Cockroach.
I was gonna say Red Bull Rat, but
that too.
Actually, HRT is not a cockroach. Cockroaches survived fucking everything.
HRT obviously didn't.
Good point. And cockroaches are actually useful for something.
And cute.
Everyone has their fish, I guess.
Yeah, whatever flows your boat, you know. Look, Schumacher's right back on boards. How unpredictable.
I wonder where he got all that pace from, because he was definitely holding everyone up earlier. Where the Merc at the pace, especially with boards not having curves. More interesting things to come, I would assume. Now, 32 seconds, see, that's definitely outside of a pit stop window. So much for the two stop. Although, then again, it really wouldn't have mattered. He doesn't have the pace.
Yeah.
It's not tire limited. So it wouldn't have mattered what he did. Unless he went for a one stop, which would have been a big ask.
Yeah.
I've got four.
wouldn't have mattered, I don't think. Like, it would have been a big ask for it and nothing much.
Well, actually, you know what? No, because if the AI is also on two stops, it wouldn't have mattered. If they were on three stops, then a one stop could have done it, but...
But he would have lost a lot more time than he...
Very true.
So...
Conditions haven't changed much. I mean, it's raining less, but it's still in weather. It's not like it got heavier when...
Well, there's no sign of a dry line forming or something like that, so...
Still interweather, it's...
I doubt that we will see dry tires this race.
I'm pretty repeat on my TV right now instead of this.
What a good caster you are.
Ah, professionalism.
Which Grand
Prix? They can't really blame me.
The most recent Grand Prix?
Yeah.
Huh. If I had to watch replay, I'd watch something from like 2007 when the cars looked good.
Cars look good, like with wings and shit?
Yes.
What would I want? Oh, when cars look good, I'd just pop in something from like 2000. Watch the McLaren.
That is pretty best. The days. The days of hacking and... Getting all hot and bothered just thinking about it.
Yeah, we...
35 seconds now.
Yeah, you see, even like even if he had a two-stop advantage, it wouldn't have mattered.
Yep.
Are you yawning? Are you bored?
Tired. I was drinking coffee, and that's now in various paper towels.
Keep pushing.
It's Glock for the second time.
Hmm.
Already on lap 33.
You guys gonna be following Timo's progress in DTM?
You got it.
When does it start? It
starts in May, I think.
Maybe.
Maybe remind me. Maybe I'll watch a few races.
He got a BMW seat in DTM, like right after Marussia canceled his contract. He already had something lined up.
Yeah.
Cool. So he must have had something, like, he must have been warned in advance. Coulthard retired from DTM. Ralf Schumacher retired, but. Block is in there, man, so that's good.
Yeah, that's both Schumachers out of their seats in the same season.
Ralf actually had a contract, but he decided he was sad. He didn't want to do it anymore.
Alright.
Okay, you should see Kurs back online now. The guys have fixed the problem.
Oh, Kurs is back.
There we go. The bitch is back.
This must make the race super interesting all of a sudden.
The pit window is open. Come in this lap.
Pit window open.
And again, on the grass there, like... It would have been another spin.
Words pit window open actually kind of surprised me, because some racing does actually have a mandated pin rules pit window. Catches me off guard. Seconds to Hamilton now.
And Schumacher is just holding station, like... Somebody get on the radio and talk to Schumacher about not passing Bortz? Or is he just not able to do anything?
No, Bortz is clearly has been pretty good at making his car as wide as the track for the last.
But he never really had to. Like, Schumacher was always far away. So they didn't really have to defend.
The wheel keeps turning and nothing changes. Bortz now 48 seconds behind.
What the? Did he just lose 10 seconds?
Yeah.
In one sector, basically?
In a couple laps, yeah.
Holy shit.
Yep.
Schumacher pitted.
Yeah, he suddenly got. He was third suddenly, but that's because the pit lane cut.
Yeah.
I was actually kind of surprised.
We knew what was going on, but you were oblivious.
Oblivious. And there's Lewis in the McLaren pits. Lol.
What?
Lewis in the McLaren pits in Malaysia.
Oh, blah. I forget that you're watching the replay.
I actually really like how McLaren responded to that on Twitter and stuff. Like, they tweeted something about, hey Lewis, stop by any time, and or something like that. And even like, did you see the replay from the Pit Lane channel?
They were like laughing like crazy.
Yeah, where they came back in after their pit stops and just laughed their ass off on the replay.
Got 30 minutes of running to go, and I think he'll make this race to the end.
Hanging the tray on that curb there.
Yep.
It looks like a solid P3 there.
It better not end like this. I feel really fucking disappointed.
What is gonna change though?
I don't know. It suddenly gets dry.
Here we go.
The Caterham mechanics borrow the wheel nut gun from Force India.
Is that Paris right behind him in the pit lane?
Yes. Yes, it is.
That'll be kind of interesting if he can keep his position.
Yeah, you said Paris behind him, and I was looking in the mirrors for a McLaren car.
And that is Paris past.
Here we go.
Yep.
Good job, Caterham pit crew. Good job.
There's Schumacher.
Is that? Oh God. Oh, thank you. Thanks a lot. Well, there's the podium finish thrown out the window.
Bye-bye.
By a combination.
Well, there's still 30 minutes to go to get that position back.
But they're quicker.
Are they, though?
Yeah.
I remember Bortz passing Schumacher.
Yeah.
Schumacher left his ass for that entire second stint, pretty much. It's debatable.
Whatever is with the Caterham car in these races, it's always like really quick in the beginning and then
shit
nowhere. Yeah,
but that's been like that for since they joined F1. Like,
has it?
Yeah, over the last few seasons, like Caterham always on their first stint, they were way up there fighting with the midfield, and then they just dropped back.
That's usually because Heike got a good start.
Yeah.
But I guess.
Bring Heike back.
Yeah.
I want to at least look at the live timing and think like, ooh, there's a Caterham in front of a Williams. And in front of a Marussia.
Yeah, look, there's a Caterham in front of Max Chilton. Well, he's a waste of space, so don't matter.
Well, yeah, but that's not like, that's not an accomplishment to finish ahead of Max Chilton.
I get it. Max Chilton.
It is. Isn't that bad? Come on now.
But come on, compared to his teammate.
Well, I'm sorry, Jules Bianchi is really good. Happens.
Yeah, shit happens, I guess.
Well, he is actually keeping pace with Perez, I guess, sorta, kinda.
Oh, you're talking about this race. I forgot we were casting a race.
Meanwhile, Matt is looking at some Russian something dash on the internet while having the race in the background somewhere.
Can you honestly blame him?
Well, it's a very exciting race. Because Alonso just set a fastest lap that's again 3 seconds faster than Bortz.
I can't.
Oh!
That was good.
That's one slow Marussia.
Good job, Andrew. And it's not even like Andrew's fault. I mean, he's doing everything right. It's just, if this fucking thing had a proper replay system, this would not be an issue. We're faster than the guy
ahead in sector. Yeah, let's blame Codemasters.
Well,
it's worked.
Well, we do.
What else do we blame? I mean, God. Like, even in conditions like these, do you honestly expect that all of the drivers would go in these stages of the race without making any mistakes? Without bringing out a yellow flag or two?
They brought out one at the beginning.
Yeah, inning.
And I'm assuming there would have just won locally whenever the second place car went boom.
Yeah. Yeah, I imagine so. But still, you know, that's
long in the past.
Processional most of the time. This is pretty processional. Like, if there were replays, we could see how Schumacher went through his quick lap, we could see him re-enter in front of both Perez and Bortz, we could do like a side of the pit stops, you know.
We could cut a proper race replay together.
F1.
No. Exactly. But no. So sorry everybody who watches this. I mean, that's the reason there's such a limited market for these videos, is because you got to follow one driver.
Yeah.
Arm would be so much better if we could do,
like,
body butt.
Maybe we do need to pressure Bortz into doing iRacing, because I'm pretty sure that allows you to watch replays.
Yeah, we should pressure Bortz into doing iRacing. We'd be good.
Or like R Factor. And the damage system is better in both of those. Or
what kind
of
damage system is there in F1 2012? Wing on, wing off.
Pretty much. No, I really don't get it. Like, I don't dislike this game. I haven't played it actually, so I like F1 2011. But get a normal damage system. Grand Prix 4 had a better damage system. Somehow.
Yeah, but then there's people like Ferrari who's saying like, oh no, you can't show our car with only 3 wheels and the broken rear wing because it's a Ferrari and people should think that a Ferrari is like the supercar and it never breaks. That's why they don't have a damage. That's why they don't have a damage system proper damage system in those kind of games, because like the brands and are just saying that it reflects on them in a bad light.
Yeah, to be fair, Codemasters actually have pulled off a pretty good damage system in Dirt 3. We've all seen that. That's pretty decent. With
they know how to do it, but they just don't.
I guess.
Well,
and in Grid, it's excellent. By the way, I'm so buying Grid too.
No cockpit, no buy.
Oh, yeah.
Well, there's no cockpit view?
No.
Yeah. They took that out because I don't know why. Because not a lot of people use it, I think, some shit like that.
That is like. Seriously, they did that? Like, that's like the worst design decision ever. Like, you're doing a racing game, why don't you have cockpit view?
Shit, we pissed something off.
I think.
Oh, it's so easy to do. Like, it's not even that hard. It's just.
Hey, Matt.
Oh, Matt. Rant over, I'm not gonna even talk about it anymore.
Valentin, I'm scared.
Yeah.
That's just like,
holy shit, we're catching Ruda! Like, we're up Ruda! Look at him, his wrestlers!
Oh, no, behind Della Rose! Now, something is happening. Come forward.
Pay attention, everybody. Things are happening in this race. We're on lap 40. It took about an hour, but we're finally getting somewhere. We're now on Perez's ass, who is on Schumacher's ass. We could have that podium slot back.
I told you so. I'm not gonna. Yeah.
Kimi come from? Kimi up in P6 from P19 or wherever the hell he started.
No, give me the not start.
He did.
He did not start. He did not start, but suddenly he's in P6.
Fuck you.
Sorry.
I do have Bortz maybe Dust Brit or something, because that's the one that counts over. Short.
When there's no cop.
Hey, you know, racing and not cockpit, but don't you think this would be a bit more fun to watch if we didn't have to stare at the fucking steering wheel for...
Well, if it shipped around to the other people's steering wheels, it'd be whoa for its cussing.
No, we do TV cameras then. Why would we shift around a steering wheel? That's silly. It's a limited view, that's the whole point. It limits your ability to see what's going on, and when you're commenting the race, you want to see as much as possible.
But still, to remove cockpit views in a racing game, when every other racing game you make has cockpit views.
That is bad, I agree.
You want to play a racing game because you want to feel like a race car driver, right?
Yeah, yes.
How do you feel like a race car driver? By being like 2 meters behind the car and 3 meters up? That's not how a racing car driver works. He sits in the car, in the cockpit. Why don't you have cockpit view? Make me feel like I'm a racing driver if I want to play a game.
I really, like, really, really offensive jokes. I'm not gonna...
Wow. Right ahead. I mean, this is back north with F1 endorsed.
I thought we should message Bortz and tell, like, when Marvin gets really mad, we should dub his lines over with Guesser.
With what?
With Hitler.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, Lord. Wow!
Oh, Jesus.
Okay. And that, ladies and gentlemen, what happens when a German goes on a rant about racing games?
Oh god, my fucking... Oh my god, my battery's running out. What the shit?
What the fuck? This cast just went from horrible to worse.
If you're German, sorry. But these videos are...
Yeah, whoa. Meanwhile, in the race, Bortz has 11 laps left to get his podium back. We believe
the car ahead and he's lapped down on fuel.
Well, let's... It's nothing new. Same procedure as every race, I guess.
Drain it till the end and then panic.
And then run out of fuel on the last lap.
Indeed. I wonder who Grosjean crashed into this race.
I just wait until the race where Grosjean and Maldonado crash into each other.
Do we forget that?
Yeah, he crashed. There was like a huge pile up, yeah.
Fuel minus one lap. Oh. Yeah, that's what we needed.
Let's see. How much time is there left in this thing?
20 minutes.
Ooh. It's gonna be really emotional. And I already got one speeding ticket this year, I don't need to get two.
You already got one what? Speeding ticket? Oh.
Note, if you drive in the US, in many states, talking on your cell phone is a secondary offense. Meaning that if you floor it to get around some idiot bitch on her cell phone, you'll get the ticket, she won't.
Tickets for you for mobile? What?
Basically, it being a secondary offense means they can't pull you over for it unless they have to pull you over for something else. And then they can tack that on. But they can't just pull you.
That is a stupid system.
stupidest thing ever. Fucking god.
Oh yeah, by the way, you drove too fast, but... By the way, you also talked on the phone, so yeah, and you chewed a gum, by the way, and yeah, we're just gonna pile that up on one huge bill, and then...
Nah, that's really the
phone illegal, or don't. This middle ground shit.
Yeah.
Yep. While you're driving is only bad.
Fighting, so I was just like, I just want to get on with my day. Here, give me the paper, I'll sign it. But, like, I'm gonna fight it in court, because it's like, look, I might have floored it a little too hard, but I wasn't gonna sit behind somebody going 10 miles an hour under when they're driving erratically. I'm just not. So, sucks.
Topics did we cover today? I'll tell you one topic that we did not cover. This race.
Not covered.
We so, did, kinda.
Kinda, sorry.
What didn't we
cover? Second gap to the car behind. 4 seconds.
Well, Bortz is kinda losing ground to Paris and Schumacher now.
Again.
And only 9 laps to go, 8 of those with actual fuel on board.
Push the car for the last lap.
Wow, not much is happening, is it? Well, at least when this is done, I can go back to Football Manager. And installing Bioshock Infinite. Hell yeah.
Such a good game.
Is it?
I liked 1 and 2. Not like I have to get the new one right away, like, but since it was gifted to me, might as well.
Never played the first one, never played the second one, don't care about this one.
Yeah, makes sense.
With my paycheck from Bortz.
You keep talking about this paycheck thing.
Yeah.
I do. Most of it was rollover money from when I was doing solo casts.
Yeah, sure.
That's what I would have said.
Are we not marketable or something? Is that what you mean?
Well,
we got some pretty good responses from the last cast.
Yeah. Eating, you douchebag. Only Steve's making sense.
Although, I do like how that guy mentioned he was here before I joined, which means he's been a real long-time follower. That's kind of cool.
Who's been here?
One of the guys who was talking in the comments. He was mentioning how he's been following the series since before I even came along.
Oh, so was I, so was Marvin.
Yeah, that's a thing. Yeah. Cool to think about.
Like, when did he start, like, 2010? 2011?
Well, 2010.
Well, you came along when you did the first podcast, right?
Yeah.
Or the co-commentary on the race. I don't quite remember. I think
it's the co-commentary. The co-commentary was my debut.
Okay.
And then
I did the podcast, I think.
Yeah, so did I.
Uh-huh.
What a nice history lesson we just did here.
7 laps to go, and it looks like Kimmy's getting impatient.
Yeah.
But, looks like the Trove GP have started social event something GP at some time.
Yeah.
But the fuel is optimal again, so Bortz actually can make it to the end of the race.
Nice change of pace.
And we.
Okay. Kim is going to make the move and he's going to overtake and it'll be okay. And let us see, it looks like, it sounded like someone just hit Kimmy back then. Probably Grosjean.
Yeah.
Well, there's clearly not enough space on the screen to show us who's behind Kimi. I mean, that'd just be preposterous. Fuck.
Just a random fuck.
Nope. It's the best.
Not, not so random.
I'm just like, give me that gun and he's not going to make them.
No, first no, it's the AI, it's not going to make a move. What the fuck is going on here?
So wait for Bortz to make the fuck up and it... Yeah. We shall see what happens and then... It'll be...
So did everybody go on a two-stopper?
I think so, pretty much. Bortz, he was being sneaky, but it turns out that was the optimal... optimal up.
Yeah.
Fastest lap of Hamilton.
142.
Yeah, Bortz is only 1 second off the fastest time race.
For the end race. True enough. Which honestly begs the question, how fucking quick is Raikkonen?
Whoever's mind reckoning just spun.
Oh.
In the middle.
I guess it's confirmed it's either Grosjean or Maldonado then.
Yeah, pretty much.
Right. Grosjean?
Believe
actually, it. I guess. Matt Grosjean. Who else has trouble driving in the rain?
Senna did.
No, it's not about driving in the rain. It's like, who else has trouble driving?
Well, specifically in the rain, who else? You know, Kimi. Kimi's a three driver. He could drive, but...
I don't remember how Kimi does in the rain, to be honest.
Brazil?
I don't even remember how he did there. I guess he had a pretty anonymous run.
Brazil last year? The one where he gate?
What?
The gate that was left closed?
Okay, yeah, he went off track and started exploring new...
new avenues. It would have been...
He was just mapping, like, the new track designs or something.
But if they're off the track and, like, onto the highway or something, they're like, oh, shit, I'm not supposed to be here.
No, Bortz is switching to lean. Yes, he is really scared about that fuel situation.
He should be scared about the finish situation behind him.
It's like, but unless he makes some huge mistake, I doubt that the AI is gonna overtake him.
Shamama duck.
Because Kimi is not like fast enough to pass him on the straight, and I doubt that he'll make a really good move in the corner.
It's the AI, that'll never make a good move. Ahead of us. Back corner a little bit hot, but gathered it up. I think that sums up this race. Oh! Oh. Damn.
See, like, even though Bortz...
Oh.
What penalty? Oh! Awesome, what?
You know, you touch the Kimi, you'll get the penalty, asshole.
Well, yeah, Kimi's fun. Looks you know like what? Button is in P6, he started P24. And we lost another car, by the way.
And I think it was the car that...
Kimi. Well, Bortz touched Kimi. Now Kimi's gonna touch him and then at the end of the race. And it will be...
Is it fun to like do like a lot of replays of that event and show who was really at fault? But there's no fucking replay system, so we can't, can we? I think Bortz should just race without penalties. Like, what's the fucking point? It's not like the AI ever gets them. It's not like he ever intentionally rams cars over. And when he does, it probably won't penalize him because it sucks.
Yeah, I'm just gonna let you rant on that one. It's worth
it.
Being useless as ever. Oh, the final left because he was multiple laps down, it's still showing Karthik Kai in his 23rd, even though they're only 22 cars on the track. That, and the most interesting thing to happen in the one. No, I do not consider the penalty. No. That's not interesting just because it's bullshit. Anywho, Lizzle. But, if you catch Bortz, well, it won't matter because Bortz is a 22nd penalty, so. Gonna guess Bortz is gonna finish around P8 or something like that. Assuming your silence means you agree.
Yes. I guess so, like 7, 8, 9.
This system.
Sorry. We can't tell because we don't know how far away the other cars are.
Yeah.
I mean, like, P7 could be like 50 seconds off. We don't know.
There's no way for him to find out, too. Even the race director does not give you the gaps.
Like, right now, it would be pretty interesting to know what the gaps are. Could be like that P8 is like 19 seconds away.
Say, Cody, how hard is it to code this type of thing? Forza can show gaps on pretty much every single piece of the lap. And so can pretty much every other modern racing game I can think of.
Need for speed.
Yeah.
Holy shit, that's the edge of the track. Let's go sliding.
Sorry, not a lot of cars usually race in Need for Speed, but yeah.
True. Motor Storm.
Yeah. Motor Storm shows distance. Fucking love Motor Storm.
That game's amazing.
It's a great idea, too.
I love Apocalypse. I have the European version of Apocalypse.
I have Apocalypse and Pacific Rim.
I won it in a contest. And I'm glad because
it's great.
Well, I haven't played it forever, but no, I'm glad that I got it when I did because it had been delayed in America by a month because some crazy lefty bitch, some group's like, oh my god, the earthquake in Japan.
Oh god.
People were bitching about an earthquake that, you know, it sucks, you know, not making money.
But seriously?
It's a world away. It's, you know.
He said, even if it was an earthquake in America, yeah, they happen.
They happen all the time.
Not to depict an earthquake. That's a penalty. Yeah.
And that one's probably deserved. Well, probably a one for Glock as well, for blocking.
Giving him a penalty for that. Bortz was trying to get around, had to compromise his line for Glock.
Sure, that is true.
Yeah.
Technically.
Yeah.
It was kind of a questionable, but there's no way the game could determine that, and technically he did send the car into a spin.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah.
Oh god, that just went tits up for Bortz.
Yeah. He has to hope that most of the cars aren't on the lead lap.
Mind Bortz. What if he...
Never fucking mind.
Alport's going to be lucky to get a point out of this.
I doubt it. Like, we haven't seen any Williamses or Toro Rosso's or something like that.
7 behind him, there's 8. And he has 40 seconds worth of penalty and he just missed a gear. There's 9. Where's P10? There's P10. And 11...
That's not going to be a point.
I don't think he's getting a point. I think he's going to finish P11. Especially if he does that kind of shit. Well, part and for Andrew. Solid race. A clean race. Wow.
Well, there is some stuff happening behind him. Like, Hülkenberg just got passed by Raikkonen.
Which would have been great to see. So it turns out Kimi did not get knocked out of the race. I wonder who did then.
How about... No, Hülkenberg was just in the race. probably Red Bull. We haven't seen a Red Bull all race.
Well, we know that P2 was a Red Bull and went out very early. And I don't know what the second one is.
We don't know.
Yeah, because we can't, you know.
We can't know.
It's the final lap.
And fuel is at -1 again on the final lap.
Aquaplane like mad, and Fernando won the race. It's the fastest lap. I think it was Vettel that got knocked out.
I really do.
One of them, at least. I don't know about the other.
You've got a slight lead over Raikkonen. Don't let him catch you.
It's not going to matter, Mr. Engineer. We have 40 seconds worth of penalties. Hamilton goes faster by about a second, but still finishes second. Schumacher going to get a podium unless Perez takes him. And Raikkonen's right up there again. The silence pretty much sums up the Grand Prix, though.
I mean, it was a good race by Andrew.
Good race by him, or from our...
Until, like, the last 10 laps or something where a bunch of stuff happened, he was pretty much set for P3 for most of the race.
And then fell back with set for P5 until 40 seconds of penalties, none of which was deserved. So that's the race. Let's see where he finishes. I'm going to guess P11. 9th! Oh, alright, there you go.
9? Whoa.
Let's see how it all panned out. Schumacher, P3, we know who 1 and 2 are, obviously.
Well done.
Good drive. Perez, Raikkonen, Hulkenberg, Ricciardo. Ricciardo doing well. Kobayashi fell apart at the end, pretty much. Maldonado finished the race, that's a shock. Let's see.
Both Red Bulls?
Weber. Both Red Bulls, wow.
They crashed into each other! Conspiracy!
You're still third in the Drivers' Championship.
So Vettel is P3 on the grid, meaning he was the first one to go out, and then Weber might have gotten caught up in that whole tangle we had with Raikkonen.
Maybe. We will never know.
It's what Codemaster says, a shit replay system. So anyway, it's 1:02. I have... Oh, God. As I'm stretching now, I have 18 minutes to get to campus, park my car, get to class, and all that fun. Yeah. High fives from everybody. Random lip moving. Not making any sense. Here comes the man hug. Or not. That's it. See you guys later.
Bye.